Everyone this morning.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
Yes, it's good to be in the house of the Lord this morning on this first Sunday in November. How did everyone feel about getting an extra hour of sleep?
Amen.
Amen. just going to be a little dark this early. You know, be looking at football and it's going to be dark, but that's okay.
Amen.
Make it through. It's good to be in the house of the Lord this morning. Our pastor, I think, will be back today. He won't be here, but it'll be important. So we just thank God that we have Pastor Donnell here this morning. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. So this morning, to get going, we come out in the 111th Psalm for our call to worship this morning, knowing that we praise God, we want to give him our best. You know, we ready to give my best and praise and worship to come here this morning, because sometimes we can't be here every Sunday. So we make the most of what we, when we're in the presence of God in the sanctuary, we make the most of it. So it's good just being in the house of the Lord this morning. You know, when people, and I just say this real quick, on Easter Sunday, people will go in and wear their best clothes. You know, that's a tradition, right? And there's a tradition, too, that some people who don't go to church all year or go to church on Easter Sunday.
Amen.
So they get the children dressed up and go on Easter Sunday.
Yeah.
And that came from, you know, they want to give God their best.
Mm-hmm.
So you dress up on Sunday, even growing up. You know, we didn't have a whole lot of money, but on Sunday we try to find the best clothes we had, the ones without any holes in them. And we'll put them on for Sunday.
Yeah.
Because we want to go and give God our best. So the only reason I say that is this one, in praise and worship, we want to give God our best.
Right.
Praising him. We were created to praise him.
That's
hallelujah.
Right.
So let's stand to your feet if you can. And Minister Jay, I hope I don't get no feedback. Close your ears, ladies, just in case. Okay, I got a little bit, so be careful with that. And Antoine is already reacting. So he didn't get them all, did he? Still got the feedback. So we had a person come in yesterday to look at our mics, and it's still, we didn't get this one mic. But anyway, this the 111th Psalm. And there's an exclamation point behind this first part, right? So let's all go together. Praise the Lord. I will thank the Lord
with all my heart as I meet with his people. How amazing are the deeds of the Lord.
Let's do that again, because there's an exclamation point behind that one too, right? How amazing are the deeds
of the Lord.
All who delight in him should ponder them. Everything he does reveals his glory
and majesty. His righteousness never fails.
He calls us to remember his wonderful works.
How gracious and merciful is our Lord.
He gives food to those who fear him. He always remembers his covenant. He has shown his great power to his people by giving them the lands of the nations. All he does is just and good, and all his commandments are untrustworthy. They are ever true to be obeyed faithfully and with integrity.
He has paid a full ransom for his people. He has guaranteed his covenant with them forever. What a holy, awe-inspiring name he has. Fear of the Lord is the foundation of true wisdom. All who obey his commandments will grow in wisdom. Let's read verse 10 again, and this is primarily for the young people. Understanding this, and as we read it, fear of the Lord is the foundation of true wisdom. All who obey his commandments will grow in wisdom. For Jacoria, Jaleesa, for Anthony, for Michael, always keep that in mind. That always fear and reverence of the Lord is true wisdom. And as we get prepared to go for the invocation, remember we got responsive reading this morning. And this is Communion Sunday. So let's go to the throne of grace. Precious Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God,
yes.
It's just so good to be in your house this morning, Heavenly Father. It's your house, dear God. Not my house, not the pastor's house, not deacon's house, no one's house. It's your house, dear God. And so, dear God, as we come in your house to worship you, we want to worship you in spirit and in truth. Our spirits are all connected to you, Lord, and everything that comes out of our mouth is in truth, Heavenly Father. So we just thank you, dear God, for being who you are this morning. Because awesome as you are, you are so awe-inspiring, Heavenly Father. We feel you in that reverence because you are our Heavenly Father. You watch over us, dear God. And when, as we talked about this morning, knowing that we may be talking about things that may have happened in the Old Testament, Heavenly Father, that whatever your word is, you won't change. You're the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. You won't change, Heavenly Father. Although we may try to change, we won't. But in this house this morning, we're going to serve you, Heavenly Father. And by serving you, Heavenly Father, we're going to praise you. We're going to praise you with the word. Pastor going to bring forth the word, Heavenly Father. We're going to praise you with our mouths, with our lips. That, dear God, with our lips, dear God, we're going to just give it all to you. Because you've just been so good to us, Heavenly Father. And even though we think we have been punished for something, you're still being good to us, Heavenly Father. Sometimes it just takes a minute for us to realize that. So we thank you for being all that, Heavenly Father. We thank you for being the potter, and we are the clay. And Lord, you're just so awesome in what you do. So this morning, we're going to praise you, dear God. And dear God, you notice I've said praise about probably 10 times already, because we want to just praise you, dear God. Give you that honor. As we come in this morning, knowing that hopefully, dear God, that when we come in the door this morning, we'll be better than we were. As we're here, before we get out of here, we're going to be better, Heavenly Father. So we just thank you, dear God, for who you are. We give you all the honor and all the praise. In Jesus' name, let the saints say amen.
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 And amen.
Amen.
Glory, hallelujah. Glory. Glory. And today we have communion. As Deacon's handing out the responsive read, we'll look to change that next Minister Jay. But right now, we have our responsive reading as we're having communion today, being the first Sunday. So God is just so awesome. And we just can't praise him enough. And this is one way too, as we celebrate today with the Last Supper. Our responsive reading is coming out of Matthew, pardon me again, chapter 26, verse 20 and 25, 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 23 through 32. And I was telling someone the other day, one of the young people, I got to look up to look down so I can read. Those who have bifocals know what I'm talking about. So that's what that small reading, I got to adjust a little bit. But I'm good now because the letters are larger. When evening had come, he sat down with the 12. Now as they were eating, he said, "Assuredly, I say to you, one of you will betray me."
Then you will betray him. Answer said, "Rabbi, is it I?" He said to him, "You have said."
Lord Jesus, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
In the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. This too, as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me."
For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death till he comes.
For he who eats and drinks in an unworthy manner eats and drinks judgment to himself, not discerning the Lord's body.
For this reason, many are weak and sick among you, and many sleep.
For if we judge ourselves, we would not be judged.
But when we are judged, we are chastened, for you young people, that means discipline, by the Lord, that we may not be condemned with the word.
Therefore, whoever eats the bread or drinks this cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord.
Okay, everybody on one accord? But let a man examine himself, so let him eat of the bread and drink of the cup. I'm going to read that again, but let a man or a woman examine him or herself, so he or she would eat of the bread and drink of the cup.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Yeah, hallelujah. Amen. 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 And before we come up to praise this morning, thank you, Anthony. I wanted to point this out, this scripture, and about praise, and trying to emphasize more on praise. In Colossians 3:16, and I said a couple of weeks, made a comment in Bible study about praise. And I always think about in the New Testament, I think about this scripture. Let the word, Colossians 3:16, let the word of Christ dwell richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another. Here's the part, in songs and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in all your hearts to the Lord. Doesn't that say it all? With all your heart. So yeah. Praise in him. So again, admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to one another. The reason why words are up on the board so everybody can participate. Amen.
Amen.
And not trying to force, my praise is not your praise. So that I'm not trying to, you know, say that at all. Whatever, however God leads you. You praise him in your own way. Just like when you pay tithe, it's your relationship. But all we can do is present what the word says. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I mean, you come to praise him.
Amen.
Come to give God some praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Let's give the Lord a wave offering. Let the Lord know you are here to give him praise. The waving of your hands sometimes give God praise. If you just lift your hand, then the Lord knows you, when you give God your hands, that means you find whatever you do in God's, God will honor what you do according to his will. Amen?
Amen.
Glory to God. So let's get into the praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Listen. All things are working for my good. Hey, he's intentional, never failing. I know that all things are working for my good. Hey, he's intentional, never fail. Oh, we know that things are working for my good. I know they are. He's intentional, never fail. Oh, we know that all things are working for my good. I know they are. He's intentional. My God is. Never fail. Oh, we know that all things are working for my good. It's working for my good. All things are working for my good. I know the eye is working. The working for my good. God is working it out for me.
All things are working
for my good. Hey. Oh. It's working for me.
Yeah.
It's working for me. I don't have to worry. I don't have to worry, God. My God. It's working it out for me. It's working for me. Yeah. God is working it out for me. Don't you worry. I don't have to worry, God. It's working for me. God is working it out. My God is working it out. Yes, he is. I don't have to worry. He's working for me, yeah, my God is working. He's working it out, he's working it out. God is working it, and it's enough, my God. God is intentional. He's intentional, my God is intentional. He's intentional.
Down deep in my soul,
it's way down,
down deep
it's in all the things.
Yeah. Hang on, yeah. Baby, don't set your mood for God is on the way.
Move of God is on the way. Amen. Amen. You need to be expecting it. Amen. Be expecting the move of God. Amen. God is active and never passive. Amen. So you should be looking for him. Amen. The move of God. Amen. Truly, it is a blessing to stand before you today to do the will of God. Amen. Not the will of Donnell, because at 3 o'clock this morning, the will of Donnell wanted to stay in the bed. Amen. Amen. But the will of God, it'll do you something. Amen. It'll make you get up when you want to sit down. Amen. It'll make you cry out when you think you should be quiet. Amen. Amen. And I thank God for his move. Amen. I thank him for pushing me. Amen. And not only him, those who are around me to push me as well.
That's right.
Amen. We are to push each other.
That's right.
Amen. In God. Amen. 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 I know we will not always agree because, well, that's human nature. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. But we can have each other push us.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
If you've said something to me that I don't believe in, you know, I go research it in the scripture. You've pushed me, amen, to gain a better understanding or gain a better knowledge of what it is that you were trying to say. Amen. So we push each other. Amen. Amen. Ask that you continue to pray for Pastor Brain. Amen. He should be in the zip code this afternoon. Amen. And amen. You know, sometimes, amen, that is good to get away.
That's right.
Amen. When I mean get away, I mean you're still connected to God. Amen.
Yes. Yes.
But sometimes you need that time.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Today, it is fitting that we're going to talk about Jonah. Amen.
Yes.
Sister Christy, she always amazed me. Amen. Let's clap the hand for God's people who teach the Sunday school. Let's name them. Amen. They all do a wonderful job. Amen. Amen. Initially, I was going to stay in the back and continue to go with my word. And Sister Chris said, yeah, I'm ready. I'm good. I said, well, let me go on in here then. She's always got something inspiring to say. Amen.
Amen.
It is always great when you have a different perspective, amen, on something. Amen.
Amen.
And she provides that different perspective. Because if I just go with Donnell perspective, then that limits me. Amen.
Yes.
Amen. It limits me. And I don't want to be limited. Amen. Amen. I don't want to be limited. Amen. And so we're going to come from the Book of Jonah this morning, amen. Starting with the first chapter. When you have it, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Now the word of the Lord came unto Jonah, the son of a Amittai, saying, rise, arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and cry against it, for their wickedness is come up before me. But Jonah rose up to flee unto Tarshish from the presence of the Lord, and went down to Joppa. And he found a ship going to Tarshish. So he paid the fare thereof and went down into it, to go with them unto Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. But the Lord sent out a great wind in the sea, and there was a mighty tempest in the sea, so the ship was like to be broken. Amen. Go on over to the third chapter of Jonah, starting with the first verse. And the word of the Lord came unto Jonah the second time, saying, arise, go into Nineveh, that great city, and preach unto it the preaching that I bid thee. So Jonah arose and went unto Nineveh according to the word of the Lord. Now Nineveh was an exceeding great city of 3 days' journey. Amen.
Amen.
For a subject, amen, we serve a God who gives second chances.
Yes.
That's right.
Amen. We serve a God who gives second chances. If you read this, when I read it, there were so many other directions that I could have approached. But God said, this is what I want my people to know. Amen. It is important that when God has tasked you, is that you deliver it in the same package in which it was received.
That's right.
Amen. Not to add to or take from. Amen. It says, when it comes to God, we can never run out of second chances. We can only run out of time. Amen. Next, that you bow your heads in a word of prayer. Dearly Father, Lord, we want to thank you today. Lord, thank you, Lord, for our uprising and our laying down. Lord, thank you for, Lord, knowing our ins and our outs. And Lord, as we begin to, Lord, feast upon your word, Lord, we ask that you open up the vials of heaven, Lord, so that the anointing may saturate our souls. And Lord, we just don't want to be hearers of the word, but we want to be doers of the words as well, Father. Lord, because we've come to understand that humanity falls short. But yet you are a God that yet still gives second chances.
Yes.
In your darling son Jesus' name, we thank you and we praise you. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Now, the book of Jonah is a historical account and is also authoritative, meaning that it's the truth. Amen.
Amen.
It is absolutely the truth. And I know that some of us, we tend to think that, you know, when you read it, especially as a child, and your limited understanding, you know, a big fish? Amen?
Amen?
Now, as a child, I know that I had a fish tank.
Mm-hmm.
Amen? As a child, I had a fish tank.
That's right.
And when I was taught this story, I could just look at the fish tank and say, how?
Mm.
Amen? Well, that would be a very big fish.
Yes.
Amen? Yes. But the account of it is accurate. Many folks have said that it is impossible. Amen. Newsflash. We have a God
that's
into the impossible.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
On every situation and on every circumstances, I can say for myself that when I called upon him, amen, it was an impossible task for me. Amen. It was impossible for me, but it was just right for him.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
And so the beauty of this is that God had given him an assignment. Every one of us here today has an assignment.
That's right.
It may not have been revealed to you yet,
mm-hmm.
but you have an assignment. Even the people that come against you, they have an assignment. If you don't believe me, look at the different ones that came against the children of Israel, how God used them to come against the children of Israel to correct bad behaviors, only to come against them that came against his very own.
Amen.
Amen. And so, when we have been given this assignment, amen, some of us have been given the assignment where, one, we might have thought it was impossible, but more than likely, two, we didn't want to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Amen, Wall. Amen. It's all right if you're not with me this morning. It's okay. Amen. It's okay. And we didn't want it. Amen. But in giving the assignment, we have got to understand that it is never our will, and when God gave it to you, mm-hmm. he knew you didn't want it.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Amen?
Amen.
He knew you didn't want it. Uh-huh. I mean, let's be real. Think about how long it took some of us to come out of the cold mm-hmm. and come into a refuge.
Amen.
Amen? We didn't want to do it at first. Amen? Because the bright lights mm-hmm. or what have you, the world was just so appealing. Amen? But I've come to the understanding that I'd rather walk around dead to this world, but alive in God, than to walk around dead to this world and dead to God. Amen. Amen. And so he was given this task, and he fell short. As we all do.
Yeah.
Amen. God lets us know that all men have fallen short of the glory of God.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. Every single person has fallen short.
Uh-huh.
But the scripture tells me mm-hmm. that his grace is sufficient.
Yes. Yes.
Just when I think that there's not enough hours in the day and I need to get X, Y, and Z done, at the end, I understand that his grace was sufficient.
Yes, sir.
When I'm thinking that I'm going through and I see myself in a bad situation and I see someone else who's worse off than me,
look out.
I understand that his grace is sufficient.
That's right.
Amen. That his grace is sufficient. And so, Brother Jonah was a minor prophet, not because, you know, his contribution to the word of God.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it was just a short period. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Yeah.
Jonah is covered over four chapters. Amen? But within those four chapters, God made it an issue. He made it a point. Now, if my prophet will fall short, and I demonstrated my grace to him.
Yes.
Surely, just the one that's sitting in the congregation or the one who comes to church occasionally, he has the exact same grace.
Yes. Yes.
Because grace is, no matter what I do, Sister Maria, I couldn't earn it. There's nothing that I could do to earn his grace.
Yeah.
You know, have you ever had a circumstance or situation you just say to yourself, I don't know why they, you know, why they like me? Amen?
Yeah.
Because you got grace.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
Even in the synagogues where Jesus was preaching while his parents was off at Pentecost. Amen?
Yeah.
It said that he had grace from man. Mm-hmm. Grace and favor.
Mm-hmm.
From man. As he began to instruct. And so it lets me know that it is a absolute necessary. Amen. Because we live in a world and we function in the spirit. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Now, Jonah was given this task. And the beautiful thing about God is that he is explicit with his instructions.
Yeah.
Yes, he is.
He said, I want you to arise.
Yes.
Amen. And go to Nineveh and cry out. I want you to speak out. Amen?
Yes.
Now, just utilizing the faculties that I have, Lord, you want me to go to this great city?
Mm-hmm.
All these people who the reason I'm going is because they're wicked?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, they're going to come for me. Amen? They're not going to receive. Just thinking.
Mm-hmm.
They're not going to want to receive what it is, thus saith the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever found yourself where the word has come to you and you just didn't want to believe it?
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Amen?
The reason why you didn't want to believe it because it was something that you did not want to hear. Amen?
Amen.
You were struggling with the acceptance of what was said to you. And here we find that Jonah, he wasn't downright suffering. He was downright disobedient.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Yeah.
Disobedient. In the first chapter, you don't glean from why. Amen? But as you read along, you'll find out that Jonah's had an ought against these people.
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Yeah.
And how dare the omnipotent God send me to talk to someone who doesn't even have his spirit, that I don't like at their wickedness, and tell them God is getting ready to move, to give them an opportunity to change their pattern.
Amen.
To change their pattern. See, when you read the story of Jonah, you'll find out it is less about his assignment and more about him. Mm-hmm. Because his heart wasn't in the right place. Amen. Have you ever been given a task and you've done it and you did it? I'm just doing it because your heart is not in the right place. Amen. And if anybody that knows better, it should be the prophet. You know, if you read over in Corinthians, you'll find out that Brother Paul, as long as he was giving praises and blessings to the Corinthians, amen, they was willing to receive him. But the moment he would let them know that they were out of pocket, they didn't want to hear.
Amen?
See, we have got to understand that there's two sides of the pillow. And that when God is giving this to us, he's not concerned about your side. Amen? He's not concerned about your side. And so Jonah was struggling with the assignment that God had gave him. Now, to shore up the belief or the understanding that the story, the account of Jonah did happen, I'm going to ask that you go to Matthew 12 and 40. Amen? Just for briefly. Now, in your scripture, what I'm going to read, it should be in red, meaning that Christ spoke it.
Mm-hmm.
And it reads, it says, "For as Jonah's was 3 days and three nights in the whale's belly, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth." Amen. Also, he speaks about Jonah in the 16th chapter and the 4th verse. Amen. Now, I don't know if this was strategically placed so that it was in red, but they tell me that he is the way, the truth, and the light.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore, if he made mention of it, then the record is true.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
God gives us all the opportunity to overcome our setbacks. One, because he knows that you were going to have them. He knew that Jonah was going to have a problem with what God told him. But even as Michael Jackson said, he says, "I'm starting with me, the man in the mirror." Amen?
Amen.
I need to start with myself to get myself right. Because even though the city was wicked, sin is sin alone.
Yeah.
Amen. Meaning there's no big one and there's no little one. And disobedience and all these other things that are going on in this city, well, it is the same. Amen. So but God utilizes Jonah. God takes the opportunity to make us an example. Amen. Makes us the example that when you fall, I'm yet still in it. If you don't believe me, the 17th verse says, in Jonah, the 17th verse of the first chapter says, now the Lord prepared. Amen. It says he prepared a great fish to swallow up Jonah, and Jonah was in the belly of the fish 3 days and three nights. Prepared, past tense. He had already prepared because he knew what Jonah was going to do. Now, being in the belly of a fish, you got to think of it being disgusting. The acid, the dampness, here it is. But even in a bad situation, he was yet still protected. Oh, yes. Amen?
Amen?
He was yet still protected. God will yet still protect you.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Right.
Now, have you ever been given a second chance?
Yes, sir.
A second chance ultimately is the baseline of what not to do.
Mm-hmm.
It gives you the opportunity to overcome.
Amen.
As Deacon said, is to get it right.
Amen.
And God was, the whole time, he was making a point. Sometimes in your situation that you've gotten yourself in is so that God can prove a point and so that he can bring you out.
There you go.
In it.
Amen.
He's got to prove a point.
Amen.
So you see, so sometimes if I tell you don't touch the iron, touch the iron, touch the iron, you won't receive it. But the moment that you touch it, amen, it's a learning moment. Now, in Jonah, we find out, it says that Jonah rose up to flee. Here it is, a prophet, thinking that he can flee God. Amen. That sometimes we allow our heart to misguide us. Amen. His disdain for the Ninevites, it guided him, and therefore he wasn't thinking.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to get on a ship, go down to the river of Jordan, and thinking that you're hiding from God.
Mm-hmm.
But how many times that we, you know what, God has called us, and, well, I'm going to leave this church because I know God calling me.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Like he won't call you over in the next church. Mm-hmm. 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 Or I'm just gonna leave the town that I'm in so that nobody will know me. But yet while you out, somebody says, the Lord calling you. You don't know him. Amen. And so here it is. Jonah thought that the necessary thing to do was to leave his assignment. My Lord.
Yeah.
Romans 29:11, I believe it is, it says that the gifts and the calling of God are irrevocable. Meaning, he ain't taking them back.
Mm.
Jonah, you still got to do what it is that I told you to do.
Yeah.
Amen. No matter how long it took us to come from out of the cold and to refuge, we still had to do it. Amen.
Amen.
I could just imagine if in 1989, if I stayed on the track, where would I be in the Lord? Mm-hmm. Where would I be if I had kept my hands on the gospel pie?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And so he thought, for whatever reason, that if he could just get on this ship, amen. And I want you to just listen to this. He says, and so he paid the fare thereof and went down.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. That's what he said, right?
That was it.
And then he says that. And into it to go unto them with Tarsha from the presence of the Lord. Now in 3, you'll see that he went down twice. Amen. Whenever you're not doing the will of God as he has assigned you, just believe that it is going down.
Going down.
Amen. It's going down.
Yes.
The song says everything's going down, but the word of God. Mm-hmm. Meaning that even though you took this trip, you yet still are charged with what I've given your hands to do.
Okay.
Amen. He says, but the Lord sent out a great wind.
Mm-hmm.
See, sometimes the things that are happening in our life, we brought on ourselves.
That's all right.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We brought it on ourselves because we weren't obedient. Mm-hmm. Amen.
All right.
We didn't listen to God. And here, Jonah decided that he wouldn't listen. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
And so we find out that what Jonah did serves as a message to the believer today.
Come on, tell
me. That though you don't do what I told you to do, amen, I know for a fact that you're going to do it. Amen. You can do it now or you can do it later. But yet you're still going to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Now, our spirit and through the scripture, amen, we say or talk about change.
Come on.
But yet, we don't receive it.
Mm-hmm.
See, it is not that what went in that defiled you.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. It's what came out.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. It's what came out is what defiled you.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Jonah had some time, because what God does is when we done messed up, he put us in time out and he give us some time to think about it.
Amen.
He lets you know I think about it. Mm-hmm. You know, we all have what we say the spirit of God. And when we have his spirit, I don't need for Deke to tell me I'm wrong. Amen. The spirit should convict me by himself. Amen. Amen. If you got the spirit. Amen. And so when I know that I'm wrong, amen, then immediately I should go into the repentance mode.
Sure, right.
Amen. I should automatically go into repentance mode, because see, it is one thing that got the children of Israel in so much trouble is that their repentance, one, wasn't it true? Amen. It was situational.
Okay.
Amen. Their repentance was situational. Amen. Some of us, amen, have found ourselves in a situational praise. Oh, Lord, how I'm going to come out of this. Lord, help me. It's because the situation that you found yourself in has unctioned the praise to God. Lord, bring me out. And we know that Jonah, he sits in the belly of the whale for 3 days and 3 nights. God gave him some time out. Sometimes that God has to place you in a place where he can deal with you. Amen. Where there's nobody around. Amen. He has to put you in a place where he has to set you aside because you got too many distractions going on in order to deal with you. Amen. So Jonah has this time to think about where he went wrong. And we would look like that would be self-correcting. But we find out later on that Jonah's had some things still plaguing him.
He,
even though his situation had changed, his heart didn't.
Okay.
Amen. He still had the same heart. See, in order to change a pattern of something, you first have to change your heart.
Mm-hmm.
You got to change your heart. Amen. And so in the third, we learn in the third chapter, we learn that the Lord came unto Jonah a second time, meaning that I'm giving you a chance to get it right. Oftentimes, God gives us a second chance to get it right. And I tell you that sometimes we end up running out of time. Lord, if you bring me out this time, I'll be in church on Sunday. But however, you didn't make it that next time. Amen. That God had grown patient with you. He began to set and show all these examples and things I need you to correct. One thing I love about the God is that when he could come against us and put the full weight of his magnitude of who he is upon us, he yet still shows us the mercy.
Yeah.
Jonah did not understand that though the Ninevites wasn't God's, but they needed God. We run into people day in and day out that isn't God, but they need God. And we need to be able to communicate to them, to let them know that he is a God for you and a God for me, that his grace is sufficient. I tell you that he has more than enough. God said that if you come in out of the cold and allow me to change your heart, I tell you that you'll understand and have a relationship that knows the difference between grace and things to come. See, the grace that God has bestowed upon us, I tell you that there's nothing that I could have done to bring it upon me. I could cry out all night to the Lord, but yet and still, that doesn't mean that I'll receive his grace. But I tell you that if I serve the Lord, I know one thing, that when I receive his grace, surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life. I can turn around. What's that I see? I see grace. What is that I see? I see mercy. I tell you that Jonah didn't understand what God was trying to teach him. Sometimes we can have our own agenda.
Yes.
And not be led by the Spirit of God.
Yes.
See, you just can't do half of God's work. He says, I want you to do it all. See, just because you did this, I need you to understand that it's all, and I need you to learn from it. Sometimes we're not good at learning what God is trying to teach us. Sometimes we think it's everybody else. And it's us.
Amen.
See, the last thing that Jonah wanted to think, that he ain't talking about me. Because I got you. I got you, Lord. They're not talking about it. No. They need God too.
Amen.
If you think about the disciples, and they were trying to push the woman aside.
Yes.
Like they the only ones that want to get blessed. But sometimes you must push your way. You have to continue to holler when they telling you to shut up. My mama always told me, she said that the only mouth that don't get fed is the closed mouth. And I tell you, she began to understand the importance of the true and living God. I tell you that she had never seen him, but she had heard about him. I ain't never seen him, but I had heard about him. I've heard about the goodness of the Lord. See, that grace is something that you cannot measure. But the assignment that was given to Jonah, he did not complete it. How many of us had that assignment that we just Lord, I'm gonna say something to him, Lord. Then you come to church or as a neighbor, you're like, man, I ain't seen them in a while. Yeah, they didn't left here. What about your assignment? Now you're feeling some type of way because you did not do what God told you to do. You're wondering, Lord, why? And you got to understand, there are some things that we do will put blood on our own hands.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Scripture says, woe be unto the shepherd that scatters the flock. So that means if he scatters them, it's on his hands. Jonah, even when God gave him a second chance, he yet didn't get it right. Even when God was talking to him about the tree that provided him shade. Amen. And the tree withered up. Now he's mad with God. Do we get mad with God? Yeah, we do. Do it matter? Nope. Because God is going to do what he is going to do.
That's right. Amen.
They tell me that they cry, holy, 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 holy. Mm. All day. Mm. So he is unconcerned about whether or not you happy about it. Mm. Whether or not you like what you do. You know, we oftentimes do not like how God has brought something to our lives. Mm-hmm. But I tell you, saints of God, it's about the green pasture. It's not about how you get there. Amen?
Amen.
Because I tell you, I've been through some things to get to the green pastures. Oh, and it tastes so good. Mm-hmm. Amen. And can use it as a reference point in my life, how God has brought me out, even as he brought Jonah out.
Yeah.
Jonah is like the everyday saint. We got issues too.
Yeah.
Okay, I should have heard more amen. Okay, wake up, church. Wake up, it's okay.
We got it.
Amen. We got issues too. Amen. You don't know what Pastor Davis has to pray about in the comfort of his home.
Mm-hmm.
Just like I don't know what you have to pray about.
That's right.
In the comfort of your home. Amen. We come to church and we put on a good face sometimes.
Yeah, like
everything. Amen. And yet still struggling. Let us not think that we're better than the next. Let's not think that. God's grace is sufficient. The old song I used to hear my grandma say, it's good enough for my mother. It's good enough for my father, my brother, my sister. It's good enough. That grace that God gives us. Sure, we're going to fall. Sure, we're not going to like the assignment. Amen. And I'm almost willing to bet that there'll be a few far in between assignments that I have enjoyed. Mm-hmm. But God knew that. Because it was going to be a teachable moment behind it. Amen. That's how the testimony is created. God knew that I wasn't going to like it, and therefore he assigned it to my hands. But what God wants from us is a willing heart. He doesn't want to see the disobedience. If we don't learn anything else from the children of Israel, disobedience, it was a non-starter for God. Amen. God will work with you till he won't work with you. Amen.
Amen.
He'll work with you till he won't work with you. Because in his ability to be patient, it's not forever and forever. There comes a point to where he says that this is it. Amen. I need a change. I need an earnest change. Amen. The belly of the fish. Let's not constantly find ourselves where God has to put us in time out. Amen. Where he didn't set us in the corner. Amen. And I don't know about you, when I got set in the corner, that means it's going to be a minute before I ate. It's going to be a minute before I get something to drink. I need to go to the bathroom. Shut up. I don't want to hear it. Amen. Oh, that treatment in the corner, it ain't good. Amen. It does bring about a change.
Yes,
amen. Amen. It will change. Amen. Amen. A change. Sam Cook said, change don't come.
Yes,
amen.
Yes,
let us change on our own. Let's not let the change be so perilous for us, or so that it disrupt us in our way of thinking and how we feel about our God.
Yes.
It's all right to get chastised because we know that he loves us.
That's right.
Amen. We know this. Amen. Amen. Let us remember Jonah. Let us remember that God has worked with us and God is going to give us a second chance. Amen. We don't run out of second chances. We only run out of time.
Amen.
Don't run out of time, saints.
Amen.
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 Worth saving, so you came and changed my life. You thought I was worth keeping, so you cleaned me up inside. You thought I was to die for. You sacrificed your life so I could be free, could be whole, could tell. We're saving, oh God. So you came and changed my life. You thought I was worth keeping, so you cleaned me up inside. You thought I was a die for. So you sacrificed your life so I could be free,
so I could be whole,
so I could tell. You cleaned me up,
so you cleaned me up inside.
You thought I was to die for.
He'll let it rain for.
So you sacrificed your life so I could be free,
so I could be whole,
so I could tell everyone I know.
Thought I was worth saving. savior. A wretched wretch like me. He offered me salvation. If you just come to him and say, for God I live, for God I die. Yes. It's giving time, church.
Amen.
Second Corinthians, verse chapter 9, 6 to 8, read as thus. Remember this, whoever sows sparingly would also reap sparingly. Whoever sows generously would also reap generously. Each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to bless you abundantly so that in all things, at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. Give, and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together,
and running over,
will be poured into your lap. With the measure you use,
it will be measured to you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Father God, most gracious Father, we thank you for your protection day in and day out.
Yes, Lord.
Watching over us as we slept in slumber last night and waking us up this morning to a lovely day.
Mm.
We thank you for blessing our family. We thank you for protecting each and every member here and their family. We thank you. We thank you for our pastors, Pastor Davis, delivered the word.
Yes.
We also thank you for my sister Christy for delivering the Sunday school lesson this morning. Yes. We ask that you make sure that our pastors Ray and his wife are back safely and sound from their time off, which is so much deserved. We ask all these things in your gracious Father's name. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. And amen. Amen. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Mm-hmm.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy.
Welcome everybody, but everyone's, I think we got all family here today, so welcome again.
Yes.
That's been done, hallelujah. So we'll move on and talk about the announcements today, just our standing announcements, and in some way we got off with the feedback. Our Sunday school is at 9 o'clock every Sunday morning. Again, as Deacon's already said, Sister Trista did a fantastic job this morning. So
amen.
If you want to get some, you know, some of that spiritual food, you know, come on Sunday morning. It's one thing to go ahead and come to church and listen to a message that fills us up.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
But we know that's one, if you will, for especially that's one direction, right?
Amen.
The message is going out.
Amen.
But there's no interaction per se. Your interaction is with amen and that's your name. But you can't, you know, it's hard to ask questions. Hey, Pastor, stop in the middle of that. What did you say? What you were preaching about? Stop. So how do you get that? You get in Sunday school and also on Wednesdays at Bible study. That's how you get it. That's how you interact and that's how you expand your learning. So encourage all of you to come out if you can for at 9 o'clock on Sunday mornings or on every Wednesday, excuse me, at 7 p.m. for the military folks. You know, it's 1900 hours. Come on out. 6:30. 6:30. Okay. 6:30, I'm sorry, 18:30 I was there, my bad. Okay, make sure you come on out or if you're on Facebook. We're still in the book of Colossians, wrapping up, so on Wednesday night. So if you can, participate with the Facebook land, but if you can come out physically, it's better because then you can ask and participate with your questions.
That's right.
If you can. And same on Sunday school, too. Okay, Givelify is a way of our online giving, and we, you know, some people don't even take checkbooks or don't like to carry checkbooks. Some people don't even like to carry cash no more. So you got your credit card. So, you know, that's the means you can go ahead and give to the church. Also, the Daughters of Christ, my wife wouldn't let me participate with them this last Wednesday.
Daughters
of Christ, I'm sorry. Daughters of Christ. No, I'm in my lane now. Remember what the pastor said yesterday? Remember that example he gave that I said I was going to put in my book about the difference, male and female? If one came in front of him, he act one way, but the other one comes. So yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm in my lane now. And you know, you guys know what I mean. I'm in my lane.
I got you.
Yeah, I'm in my lane. So, the Daughters of Christ.
Yeah.
And again, my wife wouldn't let me come in, and she wouldn't let me listen in. So, but anyway, she did. They had a very good lesson this last Thursday. She did tell me that.
Amen.
So all the ladies participated. And again, that's the first Thursday of every month. Mm. And get that part right.
Yeah.
Okay. A double rehearsal is this Saturday is the second Sunday, so this Saturday at 2 p.m., 1400 hours for you military folks. Okay, so we got, so I told you it was in that Sister Christy. I put it in the wrong place. So anyway, with that being said, we'll come out and turn it over to the pastor as we get prepared to go ahead for our Last Supper.
And you do this, do it in remembrance of me. Take this bread, symbolic of my body, and eat in remembrance of me. As often as you do this, do it in remembrance of me. Father God, it had to be a trying situation, knowing what you was about to do. The sacrifice you made for us is unfathomable. Lord, I thank you. Because had you not, where would we be?
And as for the blood, Heavenly Father, we just thank you for sending your darling son. That dear God, we know on that day, Heavenly Father, we know that the blood was shed on Calvary's cross, Heavenly Father. That blood was shed for all our sins. But dear God, we thank that Jesus left us this right, Heavenly Father, that for the blood represents his, the wine will represent, or whatever device you will represent the blood, Heavenly Father, to cover us. But not only that, Heavenly Father, that before we partake of these sacraments, Heavenly Father, that we trust and believe that we will examine ourselves, Heavenly Father, yes. Examine ourselves to know that we will partake of these sacraments, Heavenly Father, the bread and the wine, Heavenly Father, representing the body and the blood, Heavenly Father, that making sure that we are in right standing, Heavenly Father, with you, that we have no aught against our brother or sister, Heavenly Father. So we ask, dear God, that you bless these sacraments, Heavenly Father, for the purposes that we use, Heavenly Father, for this last supper, because Lord, we don't know when you're coming back, dear God, but we just trust and believe we continue to do this until you do. So we just thank you, dear God, give you all the honor and praise in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 I ask that each saint here today to examine themselves. Amen. You need to know within yourself that you're not drinking and eating damnation to your soul. Amen. This is a relationship between you and God. Amen. Not the pastor, not the deacons, but you and God. Know for a certainty that what the undertaking that you're taking right now, amen, the implications that it has, amen, if your heart is not in the right place. Amen. Let's not be like Jonah. Make sure that your heart is in the right place.
Amen.
Go ahead, Deacon.
Okay. As you come and partake, as you please follow the God's assistant, Maria.
Bread of life, set down from glory. Many things you have earned, a holy king, a carpenter. You are the living word, say. Bread of life, set down from glory. Oh.
Then Judas, which betrayed him, answered and said, Master, is it I? He said unto him, Thou hast said. Yes. And as they were eating, Jesus took bread and blessed it and brake it and gave it to the disciples and said, Take, eat, this is my body. Eat. And he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of it, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for the many for the remissions of sins. But I say unto you, I will not drink it henceforth of this fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. And when they had sung an hymn, they went into the Mount of Olives. Drink.
Amen.
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 That time it was not no benediction.